Let's take a look at how to solve this dreaded solver pivot error that often comes up in FEA models. And we saw one of the clues was that the model might be, not properly constrained. And to understand that, we have to understand the extra degrees of freedom that Ansys is putting in. So if you imagine this to be the midline of any of the bars, and let's say this is one of the cross sections. Okay? Now, in our mathematical model, since the bar can only elongate or contract, this cross section can essentially move in this direction, okay, in the direction of the axis. But Ansys says, you know what? The midline can also bend, and it models that effect by allowing the cross section to move up or down, and also rotate like this, which is about the z-axis. And it says, you know what? It can also bend out of plane. And it models that by letting the cross section move towards you or away from you, and also rotate towards you and away from you. So it has, movement up or down, movement towards you or away from you, and then the bending, about Z and about this would be about Y. And then not only that, it also has a rotation. It has the third rotation, which is like this. It's like a twisting, which would be due to a torsion. And we haven't, and it turns out, so it says the rotation X degree of freedom, which is this mode. So if we constrain that mode, then we should be able to get rid of that. Let's do that. So I click out of here and say okay. And before I put in the extra constraint, let me go back here. So let's say at this node, okay, I have u x u y. This is what I care about. And then Ansys says also puts in uz, which we have set to zero, okay, we have constrained, and then we have basically constrained the motion in the z direction. And then it says there is a theta, a rotation, so the bending, and the rotations, one thing, so this is confusing. The rotations are written in a local coordinate system, okay, so if this is xl for this bar, and that's YL. For this bar, this would be the local coordinate system, okay? And so on. So for each of these bars, you would say it cannot, it can, Ansys says, hey, it can rotate about X in the local coordinate system, about Y, and about Z. Now these are bending modes, and since we have essentially simply supported beams, these are constrained. And this is what is giving us the headache. So at this node, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set that to zero, which means that this bar, there can be no twisting, and similarly for this bar, there can be no twisting, and that should, well, we should be able to get rid of the solver pivot error. So let me put in that extra constraint. So I'll go back to static structural. I'll say supports fixed rotation. Okay? And I want to put in the minimum number of extra constraints, because the more constraints I put in, I could get spurious, reactions. So I want to put in constraints such that I don't get any extra reactions that are not real. Okay? Actually, I should select node or vertex. And over there, I will fix theta x to be 0 and leave theta y and theta z to be free. So these will be Ansys generate algebraic equations and actually calculate that. So that I'm essentially setting theta xl for both of these bars in the local coordinate system to be 0. Okay, and so let me maybe save the project and say a prayer again. Why not? And click solve. Okay, that went through. So let me save the project again. And now answers should have the 6 degrees of freedom that we care about, and then all the other degrees of freedom, which should all be zero. And so we can move on to post-processing. Let's do that next.